They will be starting with Surah Az-Zumar. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز الحكيم. إنا أنزلنا إليك الكتاب بالحق فاعبد الله مخلصا له الدين. ألا لله الدين الخالص. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا الهمنا رشدنا واعذنا من شرور انفسنا. اللهم ارنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. امين يا رب العالمين. I have already told you that these two groups of Makki surahs, the eight from Surah Al-Furqan to Surah Al-Sajdah, eight surahs. And then from these 13 surahs, starting from Surah Al-Saba, and it will come to an end on Surah Al-Ahqaf in 26th part. They want to make 21 surahs. And the central theme of these surahs is Tawheed. Although, along with Tawheed, other articles of faith, that is resurrection, the life of hereafter, the Jannah and Jahannam, the hell and the Garden of Eden, etc., etc. These things are also discussed. Along with the institution of prophethood, Nabuwah, Risalah. But the main is, the focus is on Tawheed. And out of these, mostly the surahs are discussing the Tawheed of creed, Tawheed fil Aqeedah, theoretical Tawheed. That is, we believe in Allah is one, nobody is equal to Him, He doesn't have any associates or partners or rivals or equals, neither in His person nor in attributes. He begot none and not was begotten Himself. All these things are theoretical about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are no associates. Nobody can intercede on any behalf of any person without His permission. So all these things are, they belong to our creed, our aqidah. You may call it dogma. Or, as I'm saying, it's the theoretical aspect of Tawheed. Now the other aspect of Tawheed is practical Tawheed. To worship Allah and Allah alone. To obey Him, absolute obedience to Him only. All other obediences will be subject to His approval. We can obey our parents, we can obey our elders, we can obey our teachers, we can obey our rulers, provided their obedience doesn't mean a disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the elders, the rulers, the parents, the husband to the wife, if they say, don't do this, while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared it to be obligatory, you have to disobey. And if you don't disobey them, it means you are disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shirk. Now, you have accepted them as superior to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are accepting their command and rejecting the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, this is haram, this is haram. But maybe your parents pressurize you, do it. But now if you bow at the pressure of the parents, what does it mean? You have disobeyed Allah. So there is a very good saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, لا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. There can be no obedience to anyone who is created. All are created. Parents are created. Saints are created. Prophets are created. Everybody. في معصية الخالق. If, you know, the command of the parents is not against them, okay, obey them, no harm. If the command of the rulers is not against the deen of Allah, not against the command of Allah, okay, obey them. no harm. But when they collide with each other, then you have to cling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and disobey every other person, whosoever he might be. This is Tawheed. Now this is the practical aspect of Tawheed. And I have discussed only at the individual level, this practical aspect. This practical Tawheed now rises to the level of the state. At the level of the state, if you declare, here is sovereignty of Allah, everything is under His sovereignty, this is Tawheed. And if you accept sovereignty of someone else, he might be anyone. One individual, as it is in the monarchy, or the sovereignty belongs to the people, to the whole masses, common people. It doesn't make any difference. It is shirk in both ways. Because sovereignty belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you accept the sovereignty of Allah, and under the sovereignty of Allah, within the Sharia and commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you establish a system, social system, political system. This is called the system of caliphate, khilafah. What's the difference? There was Namrud who said, I am the Lord, I am God. He argued with Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. We have read it in Surah Al-Baqarah. Then there were Pharaohs. They used to say, Alaysani mulku Misr, I am the monarch of Misr. This Egypt is under me and the whole irrigation system is controlled by me. On the other hand, Dawood, he said, oh, I am a bondsman of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I myself am a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I only rule you according to the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Apparently he was also a king, but he was not a king, he was a caliph. Last night we read the ayah, Ya Dawood inna ja'alnaka khalifatan fil ard. Not sovereign, not king. Who was Solomon? Sulaiman alayhi salam, a caliph. What was Muhammad in Medina sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after Hijra? It was a government, no doubt. Who was the ruler? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he was a caliph, not sovereign. He was himself a bondsman of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we say in that our kalma shahadat, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. First he is a bondsman and servant of Allah, and then he is the messenger of Allah. This position of messenger of Allah is secondary. The primary position is, he is the abd of Allah. As I have pointed out many a times, the three surahs, very important surahs, in the opening ayats of all these surahs, you find this position of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as abd. It is highlighted. Subhanallazi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa. Alhamdulillahillazi anzala ala 'abdihi al-kitaba wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. Tabarakallazi nazzala al-furqana ala 'abdihi liyakuna lil-'alamin nasira. This position, he is the abd. This is superior to his position that he is a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actually, this is the practical aspect of Tawheed, which unfortunately, even those, you know, groups among the Muslim Ummah, who attach maximum importance to Tawheed, and they think about themselves, they are the Mawahideen, even they don't know this aspect. If you don't accept sovereignty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, theoretically you are believing He is one, nobody is equal to Him, nobody will be able to intercede before Him for anybody except with His permission. All these things, these are theoretical aspects of Tawheed. The practical aspect of Tawheed is ibadah. But this ibadah has to be exclusively for Him. Yesterday in my Jummah sermon here in this very center, I discuss this subject, ibadah. And today I want to repeat briefly. Quran says that all the jinns and human beings were created to do ibadah towards Allah. وما خلقت الجن والانس الا ليعبدون. All the messengers called the people to ibadah. إنا أرسلنا نوحا إلى قومه أن أنذر قومك من قبل أن يأتيهم عذاب أليم. قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره. And he called the Quran, يا أيها الناس اتقوا اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Well, what is this ibadah? Number one, total obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Absolute obedience for Him only. All the other obediences will be conditional to the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'll accept whatever you command me, provided you don't give me any order which is repugnant to the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His obedience has to be higher up. So this is actually the meaning of ibadah. But this obedience should be based on a deep love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The body of ibadah is made of obedience. But the spirit of ibadah is love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. And about this love also, you can love your spouses, you can love your children, you can love your parents, you can love your country. But love of Allah should remain supreme over all these loves. If it is so, then you are a muwahid, Unitarian. But if love of one single thing or person is more than the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now you are a mushrik. All loves, all affections to be within and below the love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُم مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. Ayah number 24 of Surah At-Tawbah. Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O people, if your fathers, your sons, your brothers, your wives, or your spouses, or your relatives, or the wealth that you have accumulated, or the business for which you keep fearing lest there should be some recession, and the houses you have built and they are very dear to you, if the love for these eight things is more in your hearts than the love of Allah and love of Muhammad and the love for jihad in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then go and wait there till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala issues His final command, gives His final judgment. And Allah is not going to guide such transgressors. Your love has to be more than anything before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger. This is Tawheed. But if something is more dear to you than Allah, now for example, if wealth, money is more dear, you are ready to grab it, although it is coming through haram means, forbidden means. What does it mean? Love for this money is more than the love for Allah. So this money has become your ma'bud. And there is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ta'is abdul dinar wa abdul dirham. Woe to the person who is abd of dinar and dirham. His name is Abdul Rahman or Abdullah. But actually, he is abd of dinar and abd of dirham. Dirham and dinar is more important to him, more dear to him than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the hadith. Ta'is abdul dinar wa abdul dirham. So this practical aspect of Tawheed is discussed, especially in the coming four surahs. Surah Al-Zumar, Surah Al-Mumin, Surah Al-Hamim al-Sajda, and finally Surah Al-Shura. Now we begin with Surah Al-Zumar.